So this is the last test case we're going to explore for heat transfer phenomena, where we have a conjugate heat transfer type of the things, where let's say something like heat exchanger or anywhere we have multiple region and we want to look at the heat transfer between fluid side, solid solid and the fluid side, okay. So in this area, the fluid is going with different velocity. In this area, fluid is going in the different velocity. You can generate in the reverse way, like heat exchanger. Whatever you think about heat exchanger, you can simulate with the help of this conjugate heat transfer type of the modeling. Okay, so here we have a walls. So this is the top air area, bottom air area, top wall area, bottom wall area. Okay, and for wall we have different thermal conductivity, and for fluid side we have a different velocity. Okay, so we have to model this and we have to simulate, then we have to run with the help of the CHT multi-region simple form. Okay, so that is the way to go. So this is conjugate heat transfer. In this we have a multi-region type of the heat transfer we want to look at. So from here, first let's explore the solver part. Okay, so application, solver area, heat transfer, and we have a multi-region form. Inside that we will find the multi-region simple form. Okay, and if you look at here, so we use the same solver for multi-conduction test case in the tutorial number 2. Okay, so here we working with the fluid as well. So what we have, we have a thermo, rho thermo, so that definitely we have to take into account the thermophysical properties. Okay, so then region property, how the region is connected, how many fluid zone we have, how many solid zones, so that property we're going to read from this. Then along with that we have a create fluid mesh, create solid mesh. Okay, then create fluid field, create solid fields. Okay, then how, based on the number of fluid zone we try to simulate, based on the solid zone we try to simulate. In between, when we solve for the, let's say, fluid side, we try to take into account all these quantities. Okay, so here let quickly open all the files and have an idea. Okay, so here we have a solve for fluid. So when we say solve for fluid, we try to solve for energy equation, then it is if it is a frozen type of the calculations. Okay, or if normal class of the calculations. Okay, we normally go for entire velocity, pressure and the energy equation as well. Okay, so then let's look at the U equations. Okay, so U equations is more like same, where we have all the G terms what we see in the Baryon Pimple form. So solver wise almost same energy equations, we have a energy base equations. Okay, and we try to look at the thermo corrector. That means when we type the thermo corrector, from this enthalpy we try to calculate the temperature field. If we have radiation, you can radiation correctors. Okay, then pressure equations. Okay, so here we try to retrieve our normal pressure, but we solve for P rho gh. okay, so that is what we're going to do. Then create create fluid mesh. So where, based on number of the zones, we try to create the fluid mesh. Okay, in the normal case we have only one zone, so we need not to, we have a create mesh only. Now we have create fluid mesh and create solid mesh based on the number of zone. Based on the number of zone, we have to also create the fluid fields. So that is what we try to look at the thermophysical property for different fluid zones. So depending on the fluid zone size, let's say in our case we have two fluid zones, so this vector become two, all have a two size, and for each zone we try to read the all the properties. Okay, so this is all important if you want to developing your own solvers. Okay, so when we want to develop a this multi zone type of the solver, it's going to be very difficult class of the coding. Okay, but because we have now not a single zone, we have multiple zones. Okay, so we have to read the all the property for individual zones. Okay, so that is all the things we try to read for individual zones. Then this is nothing but something like Cohen number calculations. Okay, continuity error calculation, all these things from the fluid side. In the similar line we have a couple of equations from solid side. Okay, so we have a few equation from the solid side. So in the solid also we're going to calculate the temperature based on the energy equation, we try to correct the thermo and we retrieve the temperature out of it. Okay, so that is the all the things one can check very quickly from this different area. Okay, so same way we have then let me see if I not miss anything from the multi-zone ion from solid side. Yeah, from the solid side we have a few things. Okay, so like solid zone corner number, diffusion numbers, read solid mesh, create solid field, all these things we have to take into account. In the similar line, the way we read the property for fluid, we have to read the property for solid as well, for different solids, same way what we did for the fluid side. So this is about the solver. Okay, so if you are interested in coding, then explore this all the entries from the solver side and have an idea how exactly it is coded. But let's explore how one can quickly set up this test case and go for calculations. Okay, so what type of test case we have? We have two fluids and two solid zones. Okay, so we have multiple zone here. So let's quickly look at the readme file. Okay, and create the environment from that area. Okay, and let's look at first clean the test case. Okay, so then let's generate first mesh. Okay, so this is the block mesh. So what we are doing, we are generating the first the common block for entire of this domain. Then for the topo, based on topo set, we generate three zone, 4 zone. Okay, so first look at the mesh, how it look like. Okay, so this is what we did. Okay, now we based on the topo set, we try to segregate this zone 1 2 1 2 3 and 4. Okay, and then we try to create the boundary condition, all these things. So first let's look at the topo set. So in from the topo set area, if that is available topo set dict file, so what we require to create the different zones. So that is exactly we are doing here. So let me open this area. Okay, so based on our requirement, okay, we are creating the zones in the topo set. So top air, that is nothing but this area. Okay, so we are constructing topo set from 0 0 to 0 1.25. then we have a bottom air, that is bottom area, this one, and in between we have a top wall and the bottom wall. So that is how we can construct the different cell zones. Okay, so that is what topo set going to give us. So let's first run the topo set command and have an idea what exactly happened after this. Okay, so after topo set, let's go back again to Paraform. If you look at and activate the sets from this, so if we activate the sets and switch off the internal options, then let's explore. We have a let's say bottom air. Okay, then we have a bottom wall, top air and top walls. So all this different zone we have. Okay, and for each of the zone, now what going to happen on this, we have a boundary condition peripheral, but what going to happen at the interface? At one side we have fluid, another side we have a solid for this interface. So for that we require the coupling boundary between the solid and the fluid. For here solid interface, and here again the solid and fluid interface. Okay, so if we say this is a top air and the top wall, so what we require the interface between the top wall to the top air to the top wall, and top wall to the top air for this. Same way top wall and bottom wall interface, and the bottom wall and the bottom air interface, that is required. Okay, so that is what we required. But before that, let's first split the cells. So that is what normally we do after creating the different zones. So we created the different regions. Okay, now after creating the region, what going to happen? First explore couple of the things. So in the this zeroth folder, okay, so how and what going to happen? This is our dummy boundary conditions. Okay, so this is our dummy conditions. So everything is like a calculated. Okay, so everything is calculated based on that. What going to happen when we say run that command region? Okay, what happened exactly? It's happened, all this zone is created here. Okay, so let me show you one more time. Let's say BKP, one folder I'm constructed, okay, and I'm dumping everything here. Similar line, just go back here, okay, and this also create folder backup. So you let's say you are starting from the scratch, what going to happen? So you at least have idea what exactly happening at each places, okay, so that give you the better prospects. So BKP, sorry, at least let's say from the scratch we are developing this entire test case, okay. So I kept everything in the backup file, and what I'm going to do, I again cleaning the test case and give you the better idea. So now the test case is clean, okay, so we have nothing in all the folders, okay, so it's like a clean test case. And only what thing we have a zonal property that we, based on our requirement, we can set it, okay. What first thing, we first create the mesh, okay. So let's say run the block mesh command. When run it, after you run the block mesh, in the constant folder we will find the polymesh one file, okay. Inside the polymesh, our mesh is generated. Now what we required, we have to generate the topo sets, okay, use the topo set and generate the multiple zones. So when you say topo sets, what going to happen, inside the poly you find the sets, three sets is created, bottom air, top air, bottom wall, top wall, okay. Now this all the sets is separate, not connected, disconnected zones, okay. Now what we require the interface in between the cells, okay. So for that we say split these zones. So for that we are using the split zone command. So after running, please check what going to happen. If you run the case in the everywhere, one again in the zero folder, we don't have any folder here. In the constant, we don't have any folder that is related to different zones. Here also we don't have any folder. So what exactly going to happen when you run this command, it not only splitting the zones, but it's also creating the required files and everything in each and every folders, okay. So each and every places. So look at the zero folder, based on our number of the zones, few more folder created, okay. Based on number of zones, this all the folders is created. Inside the folder you see the polymesh files, okay, that is respectively for each and every zones, okay. Same way in the system folder also you will see these files for FE mesh and all these files you will see, okay. So now what I did, I will delete these files. Why? Because what I in the backup, if you see bottom, I also have a all this property file I set, okay. So this is what normally required when this split zone is created, this all the property file is not there, look, only polymesh. So we have to copy that property file here and it's going to work, okay. Similar line, if you look at the system folder here, I have only FV scheme and this file, but I require one additional file that is called the chain dict file and the decompose para if you are working with the parallel. So these files I required. So what I right now doing, I'm deleting these folders and taking back from the backup part, okay. But if you are generating your own test cases, now you understand this all the files is required, okay. So that file supposed to be here by default, these two file, but we require a change directory files to manipulate the boundary conditions. Same way in the constant area, let me delete all this four folder, okay, and again retrieve the folder from our backup area. Okay, so that is why I did, because by default only I have a polymesh, but I require all the property files. So that's why I'm doing that. In the same way, in the zeroth folder, you need not to do anything, because we are running with the chain directory and we are setting the boundary condition right now. If you see, okay, so this is our dummy boundary conditions that I already told you, okay. So everything calculated. Now if you go toward the bottom air, again we have to specify boundary condition here, but here exactly based on the interface, look, bottom air has an interface with the help of the top wall, sorry, bottom wall. So that conditions is supposed to be the matching condition, not supposed to be calculated. Everything right now calculated, look. So based on our boundary condition requirement, we have to change this condition. So for that we are relying on very important utility that is called the chain dict utility. So let's observe what else we have here. So topo, top wall here, change dict. If you look at, look, we right now we are changing boundary condition for each and every variable, whatever the way we want. For temperature, we require this coupling condition between top wall top air and the top wall. Okay, and top, right now we are changing for top air. That's why in the thermo area we have fluid thermo, and kappa is not the thermal conductivity, it is coming from fluid thermo. This is the temperature that is what we want to set for the top this side. So this boundary has a temperature from this side is 293. Okay, so that is what exactly we are setting, and the velocity field we want to set as a 1 meter per second. So that is what we are setting everywhere. We see saying from the internal, so it try to retain this 1 meter per second. Max is goes as outlet, so that is what we are setting here. Also we have a top air to top wall, we have a fixed value internal calculation. Okay, so that is exactly the interface condition we are setting. Okay, so in the similar line we have all the conditions we have to set for, let's say, bottom wall or bottom air. So if you look at bottom air is coming as a 500 degree Kelvin, so we set temperature 500. Then we supposed to have this interface condition between bottom air and the bottom wall, that is this line, bottom air and bottom wall. So right now we are at the air side, so that's why we have a kappa that is coming from fluid side. Okay, and the velocity is 2 meter per second. Okay, same way pressure 101325 or 1 e to the power 5 we have, so that is what we required in the similar line. Now look at the wall side. Okay, so let's say bottom wall, so change dix. Okay, so in from the wall side what we required, we required the only the temperature condition, because it is solid part, so where are we going to solve only the energy equations. So we require only the temperature file to be modified, and what we have a, it is about the bottom side. So in the bottom side we have a temperature as a 500 degree Kelvin, so one supposed to change it to the 500 degree Kelvin whatever we required. Okay, so everywhere we say it is 500, and now kappa is coming from the solid thermo. So what we have a bottom wall to bottom air and bottom wall to top wall. Okay, where exactly we are in this zone. So one is the bottom wall to bottom air and bottom wall to top wall. So everywhere we specify, and we have to specify this property inside the constant folder, so that we are going to explore later on. But right now please check all the conditions. Okay, so that is what we one has to see here. Same way here, make sure we have a 500 degree Kelvin. Now let's look at the top wall side. So on the top wall side, change dix, if you look at we require this all the conditions as a from the this side. So let's look at something like 293 Kelvin. Okay, or you can this later on going to change. Okay, so you need not to worry about these conditions. Okay, 293. Okay, slowly it going to achieve the our desired conditions. Okay, and here is the interface in between. So this is what top wall and the bottom wall, so where we have interface of something like 500 degree Kelvin. Okay, so that is the conditions we set in as the interface conditions. And now if you look at, we have to set the different thermal conductivity, so that we're going to set inside the constant directory. So constant directory we have multiple. So about the fluid property, we supposed to set the bottom air thermophysical property here, whatever you required. Okay, same way top air thermophysical property here, top wall thermophysical property you can set here. So for that I say kappa equal to 1, and for bottom wall thermophysical property if you check, we say kappa equal to 200 degree 200. Okay, so that is how one can set entire test case. Okay, so only setting is very very crucial here. Okay, so don't mess up with the setting. After that we split the zone, but we till didn't apply this all the boundary conditions. Okay, so what going to happen, just quickly check. So right now if you look at in the condition files, so let's say top air, and if you look at the temperature conditions, till here we don't have interface conditions. Okay, so what we supposed to do, we supposed to run a this utility is called change dict utility for let's say top air. Okay, we are running for let's say top air first. So what it going to do, try to change the boundary condition for this top air. Okay, so that is exactly one can check very quickly. Okay, so this is what I am closing that and again opening the this area, if you see, every condition is set with the change utility. So in the similar line, you can run this change dictionary for all the zone, okay, and make sure we have a correct boundary condition for each and every zone. If boundary condition is failed, we're not able to run this test case correctly. Okay, now we are set for simulation, so let's run with this our multi-region form. So let's check how exactly it and what is happening. Okay, so let's see. So it's run for first fluid zone, top air. How it know what different fluid zone we have? So that I didn't mention it. You mentioned in the region property area in the constant folder. So we specify top air first, so it's going to solve for top air first and then bottom air, okay, then top wall and the bottom wall. Okay, so anyway, this order doesn't matter. So what's going to happen for the top air, it try to simulate for velocity, then energy equation, then the pressure, okay, and then go for bottom same way for top wall and the bottom wall, okay, so and then go to the next iteration. So like that way it try to simulate for all the walls. Okay, so let's again look at top wall. So look, we are going towards steady state, so it is nicely converging. Our momentum converged nicely, energy equation, pressure is also converging, temperature equation for different solids zones also converging. Okay, so we are going in the correct directions. Okay, now let's look at exactly how the results is look like. Okay, so it's not going to work like this way because now we have multiple zones, so we not going to post process straight away with the para form. For that, what is required? We require the different way. So we say para form touch all, that command is required. Okay, and when we use this command, this few files is created in terms of dot open form, and now we don't run para form, we run para view. Okay, and with the help of the para view, we able to open whatever the zone we require. So let's say we want to open all the four zones, so let's open four zones. Okay, and step by step activate the zones and activate all the variables. Okay, so zone number two, okay, for that we require this. Zone number three, temperature we require. Zone number four, temperature required. Now let's go to the last one, okay, and check the temperature. Zone number one, okay, here also let's activate the temperature. Zone number, here also activate the temperature, here also activate the temperature. Okay, so this is how temperature distribution for a multi zone type of the test case. So we have a higher temperature and slowly we have a higher temperature fluid passing through, the lower temperature fluid passing through, and how the heat transfer is happening between different zone, it's quite visible here. Okay, so I suggest try to create your own heat exchanger class of the test case. Okay, where you have multiple zones and try to set up the test case. You look at the cross flow, parallel flow, okay, counter flow, all this class of the calculation with the help of this multi zone class of the tutorial. Okay, so this is what about all the heat transfer phenomena that is possible inside the open form. So you can either go with the pure conductions, or if you have multi-zone conduction, then again you have to work with this CHT multi-region form only. You go with the forced convection, you go with the natural convection, you go with the mixed convections. I didn't talk about the radiation. You can even activate the radiative phenomena as well. So many test case you can look at in terms of this heat transfer. If you want to explore a few more test cases, I suggest it is available in the our release version. So go to the tutorial area, look at the heat transfer area for different let's say pimple form. You have a different class of test case here. You have multi region form test case here. You have multi region simple form. Certain test case about heat exchanger is here. Okay, Byron pimple form, then Byron's simple form. Okay, so many test case available. I suggest run all the test case and have a feeling how exactly it is happening. Create your own test case and also try to work with this very good heat transfer phenomena. that one can capture with the help of the open form.